Okay, guys, I know a few of you have been asking about how we punch in Wing Chun in class, especially for the student grades that just joined us at student grade one. And this is really important, you know, that you ask questions like this. So we're really promoting our classes to ask these questions. It's not a case of you ask us and we say, oh, just go train, this is right, you must learn. No, of course not. You know, you're here to learn from us and we'll answer your questions when you have them. So a big thing in Wing Chun, you know, why do we punch with vertical fist, and why we don't punch, you know, like traditional arts or traditional boxing with this sideways fist at the end. There's a few reasons, but I suppose the most obvious reason I've discussed is to do with how we fight Wing Chun and how we use our arms. We don't want to restrict ourselves, you know, in one way. So of course, if I'm going to punch like this, that's restricting my arm in one direction. You know, it's not a problem. There's no such thing as a perfect punch. Whatever punch works in a situation is going to be the best punch. We're not saying the vertical punch is best or the horizontal fist is better. No, the punch that worked is obviously going to be the best one. So the reason why we don't punch like this is Wing Chun, say for example, and I punch like this, and he pushes my arm to the side, I've got no way of twisting it. Yeah, it's already fully extended. When he pushes, it's already committed. Yeah, I can't suddenly roll out of it. It's impossible. But when I'm punching, he pushes the arm to the side here, I can do bong sao, and if he pushes it the other way, I can do tan sao. Yeah? I can't do tan sao like this, it's impossible for me to do it. Yeah? So my idea, of course, when I'm punching, and of course we would use the body when we punch, we don't just punch empty like this, or downwards, we're punching from the body and the hip and the legs. Yeah? And obviously all the joints and ligaments we talk about in class. So when I do this, and he's going to defend this, I can of course bong out and attack him, yeah? Or he parks on the inside, and I can tan out and attack him. Yeah, I can't do this if I've got a horizontal, you know, very dangerous. So this is the reason why we punch like this in Wing Chun. You know, like I said before, there's no right or wrong punch. Obviously there's ways to punch correctly, but there's no best punch. The most important thing is the punch that's best is the one that wins the fight. So we'll just go over this again. When I punch him and he pushes to the side, boom, boom. And I punch again, a different way, he pushes tan inside. Like the fifth student grade where the hand changes from the chi sao, and you're pushing and you come round. So I'll demonstrate it a bit faster. I punch. See, a little slow now, boom. Crack. See, I can do that because I've got an arm like this and it can fold either way. Yeah? So I do it again, boom. In, low, elbow. And then the inside here. So I do a couple fast. Inside. So I'm always trying to make sure that this fist is vertical and it's in line with the other joints.